interference. Under 2 minutes, under a minute and a half, actually, to play here in this third period. A giveaway now by Ollie, but he gets back to take it away and play it up on the wing. Clark MacArthur tried to play it back. That was knocked out of midair by Brad Marchand. Trying to get it back to the goal. He does. It comes in front of the net. And it is MacArthur freeing it up, and Grabovski is away. Grabovski trying to split the defense. Grabovski in. Shoots, scores! Holy Mackinaw, what a goal! Mikhail Grabovski gives the Leafs the lead with a minute one to go.
What a night for Grabovski. I mean, he gets knocked twice down by Chera, the second time knocked out a little bit. And now what does he do? He responds by this. A one on three. He splits the defense and then throws it up over top of Tim Thomas, and a beautiful short side shot as he walks Seidenberg here and then throws it up over top. And Grabovski with a solo mission here. He turns Seidenberg inside out and then head up. And then Thomas, who's been very shaky in this game, allows him to throw it up on the short side. And that's a big-time goal and a big-time night for Mikhail Grabovski.
Second goal of the season for Grabovski, his 24th of the year. And the Maple Leafs have a 4-3 lead with a minute one left to go in the third period.
And what a night. Here's the first play here as Chera gives him a ride in the first period. Then he scores, responds with a backhand goal in the second. And then here, Kerbang. And watch him get up. I mean, he can hardly get to the bench. He's out for a second there. Gets up somehow. Look at this. I thought he was done for the night. And then here he comes, plays the next shift. And then, boom. Gives his team the lead with 1:01 to go.
Cliff Fletcher got him from the Montreal Canadiens, and a lot of people scratched their head about it, but Mikhail Grabovski continues to develop, and he has had a marvelous season for Ron Wilson, and here tonight may be his greatest effort of the year. Two goals, two mammoth hits that he's taken. He takes more hits than maybe any other forward on the Leaf team, and big ones, and yet he bounces back. The resiliency is there. Thomas to the bench, shot stopped by Reimer. Bouncing puck cleared out at the center ice area. 44 seconds left as Chera's back in his own zone with Kessel chasing. Chera around back of the goal, sends it behind the net himself. Clark MacArthur gets the lone assist on the Grabovski goal. Chera through center. Shen knocks it back into the zone. Under half minute, Krejci gets it into the Leaf end. Round back into the corner as Bozak peppering it on the boards, but it's trapped by Lucic, who centers. In front of the goal, a shot, stopped by Reimer. And a rebound now and back to the blue line. Bergeron plays it in. Krejci for Lucic, looking for a man in front. Off a stick, it goes to Krejci again. Back to the blue line, knocked high in the air off a Toronto diving stick from Lupo. Down goes Campbell, centered in front of the net. Krejci, time runs out, the Leafs win it. A huge save by James Reimer in the final seconds. And the goal by Mikhail Grabovski stands up. The Leafs beat the Bruins 4-3.
And Reimer just keeps telling people and showing people he's the real deal. And saves like that put an exclamation mark on the way he has played tonight and throughout his young career here as a Maple Leaf. He saves the day in the dying seconds in regulation.
Mikhail Grabovski with his third two-goal performance of the season is star number one. Phil Kessel gets the monkey off his back with two goals against his former teammates. And James Reimer wins his sixth game on the road this year of the seven that he's had. So the Leafs win it by a score of 4-3. From all of us here in Boston, good night. Stay tuned now for Connected.